In this video, I'm going to explain what search themes for Performance Max campaigns are, how you should think about them, how you shouldn't think about them, and whether or not you should use them in your own Performance Max campaigns. Hey, this is John Horn from StubGroup. We are a top premier Google partner digital advertising agency, and we help businesses dominate Google ads and make money online. So Performance Max campaigns, search themes, what is this? What's the deal? Well, as I'm recording this video in early November of 2023, this is a relatively new feature that's released out of beta in late October from Google. Now, this has been in beta for a while, and here at StubGroup, we had the opportunity to test it out for several of our clients earlier this year, and I'll tell you more about that and what we learned from that as well as part of this video. But let's just explain what are search themes in Performance Max campaigns. So this is the ability that Google is now giving us to add a list of up to 25 words or phrases to your Performance Max asset group. And you can kind of think of it as a list of keywords. There's more nuance to that that I'll explain here in a moment as well. But you know, if you're kind of coming over from the search world, it's essentially a list of keywords that you're adding to Performance Max that do a lot more than just what keywords do on the search side of things. So like I said, you can have up to 25 per asset group. It used to be 10 back when we initially did this beta earlier this year. Now it's 25. And some of the things I'm going to explain in this video will probably change over time because this is a relatively new feature from Google. It's evolving, and they've even said themselves that things are going to change and that we're going to release more information about this in early 2024. So come back for more information as we get more information and as we see how search themes perform from a testing perspective. All right, so what do search themes let us do now that we couldn't do before? Well, essentially, we are able to inform Google, give Google more information about what we're advertising and who we want to serve our ads to. So up to this point, the kind of input signals that we have for Performance Max campaigns are the landing pages that we provide to Google. Google's crawling those, looking at the keyword phrases and pieces of information on there to see what's relevant. It is the audiences that we have told Google are relevant signals for us. So that could be first-party data, like customers, customer email addresses, phone numbers. It could be affinity audiences, custom audiences, which search themes are replacing some custom audiences. We'll get to that as well. And then, of course, it's the actual information we enter into the headlines and descriptions, and it's the shopping feeds that we provide as well if it's an e-commerce business. So those are the inputs that we've had historically into Google Performance Max campaigns to say, hey, here's what's relevant to us. Here's what you have to work with. Now Google is also essentially saying, hey, you can give us a list of keywords. Now, this is not the same thing as just a list of keywords. This is not just going to apply to the search side of things. It does apply to the search side of things. Essentially, Google is saying, okay, and there are examples they give, hey, if you are a skydiving store or a skydiving a business that helps facilitate skydiving trips, and you enter as a search theme into your Performance Max skydiving license, then when someone searches something related to skydiving license on the search side of things, Google looks at that search theme and uses that as a signal to understand that that search is relevant to your business. So in that way, it is similar conceptually to a keyword. And Google also kind of has a graph, for lack of a better word, or a funnel, where they show how Google prioritizes search themes against keywords. So from what they've released, they're saying exact match keywords that are identical to the search triggered are still the top priority from a ranking perspective. And then under that, phrase and broad match keywords or search themes that are identical to the search have the same level of priority. So in other words, if you have a search campaign with phrase and broad match keywords, and then you have a Performance Max campaign with that same phrase as a search theme, those have the same rank or the same level of priority between them. That's what Google is saying currently. However, it's not just in the search campaign that search themes are applicable and relevant. They are applicable across all the placement types that Google has. So search, shopping, display, Gmail, YouTube, Discover. Google is also using this information that you're telling it with search themes to understand what other audiences are relevant to your ads, or maybe what those people are searching for. And if they know that they searched for that thing and then they're seeing an ad on an app or a website, they know that could be someone who's relevant to see your ad as well. I'll pull up on my screen here some information and examples that they gave us earlier this year when we tested this beta earlier this year. So here are some examples, some very specific examples where they said this could be relevant. So let's say you're an insurance company. and you generally do car insurance, but your landing page doesn't prominently feature maybe some of the specialty products that you sell. So for example, insurance for people who drive but don't own a car, or SR22, which is for people who are mandated by a court to carry insurance to meet certain requirements. So as Google is giving us examples, well, you could add those phrases as search themes to your Performance Max campaign, because Google is not reading those phrases from your landing page or maybe even from your ad copy. But by providing those as search themes, you're telling Google, hey, this is also relevant to us, and you may be able to get additional traffic from people who are searching those terms and who currently aren't being served your Performance Max ads. So that's an example. Same thing also like on Gmail. So they might be, Google may have identified that these people are interested in this type of thing, and then they might show your Performance Max to them on Gmail or YouTube or display, fill in the blank. Another example they gave over here is, let's say you're a hotel and you are a hotel that's near the New York City Marathon start line. Well, that might not be something that is explicitly mentioned on your website or your landing page, but that's a very relevant contextual point for people who are searching for hotels that are near the Marathon start line. And so by giving that information to Google, you are further educating them about what types of searches and what types of people are relevant to your campaigns. So There's a lot more nuance even than this, and just kind of how you think about search themes. And this is something that we're thinking of very very intentionally as we roll this out for all of our clients. When we tested this earlier this year, we did not see significant changes in performance pre and post adding search themes. But again, Google is constantly making changes to this program. So what worked or didn't work or didn't have an impact earlier this year is not necessarily the case right now. And we are rolling this out across our clients because we see this as an important thing, an important signal that we have to test with Google to give Google more information. And then we'll see, what performance where performance goes, better or worse, as we try different search themes as well. So these are optional. You don't have to use search themes currently in Performance Max campaigns. You can remove them after you add them, so they're not set in stone once you add them. You cannot see performance by specific search theme. You're going to have to look at things more generally over time and see, okay, how is performance before and after adding these, and so forth and so on. In general, again, my recommendation is go ahead and add them and be intentional to add pieces of information that maybe Google can't already figure out from your landing page, or things that you really want to emphasize to Google, and use this as an opportunity to teach the system what is relevant to you. Again, we'll put out more information as we learn more from our own testing, and hopefully this is helpful to you. Tap that subscribe button for those additional updates, and we'll put some more videos about Performance Max on the screen here so you can read other hot takes that we have about this very important campaign type on Google. Until next time, take care.